who do they belong to? I don't know, to nobody. Well, then they belong to me, because I was the first one who thought of it. That's all it takes.
Certainly.
We have a diamond that no one has found, and you do. It is yours. When you have an island that no one has claimed, you claim that it is yours. When you have an idea, you put a patent on it, and it is yours. And this is what I have done with the stars.
Yes, I guess that's true. But if I had a silk scarf, I could just pluck it and put it around my hat. If I had a flower, I could pick it up and take it with me.
Yeah.
You cannot pull the stars down from heaven.
Huh, but I can put them in the bank.
What?
The bank. I can write down the number of stars on the paper, and then I take it and put it in a drawer where I can keep it safe.
That's all it takes.
That is enough.
It's interesting, but it's of no great consequence. My flowers, it does me some honor to own them. My volcanoes, I help them. But it is of no aid to the stars that you own them. Yes, a month. 30 minutes, 30 minutes.
Oh, look! Here's an explorer. Where do you come from?
What are you doing here? What is this book?
I am a geographer.
What is a geographer?
A geographer is a scholar who knows the locations of all the mountains, deserts, and rivers.
Finally, someone with an interesting profession. So, does this planet have any oceans?
I couldn't tell you.
Oh, does it have any tails?
I couldn't tell you.
Does it have any rivers or mountains?
I couldn't tell you that either.
But you're a geographer.
Exactly. But I'm not an explorer. I haven't gotten a single explorer on my planet. It is not the geographer who goes around to count the mountains, rivers, and deserts. The geographer is much too important to go looking about. He does not leave his desk. Instead, he takes in explorers to his study. He asks them questions and notes down what they recall of their travels. And if any one of their recollections seems interesting to them, the geographer orders an inquiry into the explorer's war character.
Why?
Because an explorer who told lies would bring disaster on the books of the geographer. So would a man who drank too much.
Why?
Because intoxicated men see double. Then the geographer would record down two mountains in a place where there was only one.
I know someone who'd make a really bad explorer.
That is possible. Then, once the moral character of the explorer is shown to be good, the geographer orders an inquiry into the explorer's discovery.
One goes to see it.
No, that would be too complicated. Instead, one requires the explorer to furnish proof. For example, if the discovery in question is that of a large mountain, one requires the explorer to bring back large stones for it. But you are an explorer. You come from a different planet. You shall describe your planet.
The planet I come from, it's very small. There's not much to it.
Well?
I have three volcanoes. Two are active. I wanted to know. But I still cannot be an active one because one never knows.
One never knows.
I also have a flower.
We do not record flowers.
Why not? The flower is the most beautiful thing on my planet.
We do not record flowers because they are ephemeral.
What does that mean, ephemeral?
Geographies are books which, of all books, deal with matters of consequence. The books are way too important for things like flowers. It is very rarely that a mountain changes its position. It is very rarely that an ocean empties itself of its water. We write of eternal.
But a volcano that's inactive can become active again. What does that mean, ephemeral?
Whether the volcano is extinct or active, it all comes down to the same thing for us. What matters to us is the mountain. It does not change.
What does that mean, ephemeral?
It means which is in danger of speedy disappearance.
Is my flower in danger of speedy disappearance?
It certainly is.
My flower is in danger of speedy disappearance. It only has four thorns to protect itself against all the world. And I've left it. I've left it and my three volcanoes. That doesn't make me a very good friend. What am I going to do?
Visit the planet Earth, and there's lots of flowers.
Conceited men, 300,000 businessmen and 400,000 drunks and so on. But grown-ups like to think they are very, have a very importance. But truth be told, they're really not. The Earth is very large, very wide, but grown-ups only take a very small portion of that Earth. But I know you have confidence in me, so trust me that when I say, if you ever come across a grown-up, do not tell them that.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Where are we landed?
Oh, this is the Earth. This is Africa.
Where are all the people?
This is the desert. No people in the desert.
I wonder if the stars are aligned, so my planet is right above this place.
It is beautiful. What has brought me here?
I was having some problems with my flower.
Uh-huh.
It's very lonely in the desert.
It is also lonely among men.
You're very funny, creature. You can't even move. You're not even powerful. You don't even have legs.
I can carry you farther than any ship can take you. Whomever I touch, I send back to the Earth from whence you came. But you're so innocent and true. And you come from a star. You move me to pity. You're so weak on this earthly planet. I can help you one day when you grow to homesick for our planet. I can.
I understand. But why do you speak in riddles?
Stop them all.
But there's no shop anywhere where we could buy friendship. So, as a consequence, men
On the earth, one sees all sorts of things. But this is not our earth. On another planet?
Yeah. Does this planet have objects?
No.
Interesting! Are there chickens?
No.
No. Well, nothing is perfect. My life is very monotonous. I hunt chickens, men hunt me. All the chickens are just alike, all the men are just alike, and as a consequence, I'm a little bored.
But if you tame me, it will be as if the sun has come to shine on my life. I will know the sound of the step different from other steps. Other steps will send me hurrying back to the ground. Yours will call me, like music, from my door. And look, you see the forest down yonder? I have no need of wood. The trees have nothing to say to me. And that is sad. But your hair, it is the color of bark. Think how wonderful that will be once you have tamed me. The trees, which are also brown, will bring me back the thought of you. And I should love to listen to the wind of the branches. Oh, please tame me. What would I have to do to tame you? Oh, oh, you must be very patient. First, you will sit down a little distance away from me. Like that, in the center. And I will look at you out of the corner of my eye. And you should say nothing. Words are the source of misunderstandings. Each day, you will move a little bit closer.
So then the fox went away, and the little prince returned to her the next day.
It wouldn't be better to come back at the same hour. If, for example, you come at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, at 3 o'clock, I will begin to feel happy. I will feel happier and happier as the hour advances. Then at 4 o'clock, I will already be leaping and worrying about. I shall show you how happy I am. But if you come at just any time, I will never know when my heart is to be ready to greet you. One must observe the proper rites.
What are rites?
Oh, these are actions also too often neglected. They are what make one day different from other days, one hour different from other hours. There is a rite, for example, of the Mycotters. Every Thursday, they go dancing with the village girls. So Thursday is a wonderful day for me. I can walk as far as the vineyards. But if they went hunting at just any time, everything will be just like every other day, and I will never have any vacation at all. Are you beginning to understand now?
Yes.
So the little prince went away one final time and successfully tamed the fox. But then came the time for the prince's departure.
I should not have tamed him. But you asked me to. Yes, and now you're going to cry. That is so. It's done you no good then. It has done me good, because of the color of the bark. You will understand now that your rose is unique in all the world. My rose is unique in all the world. I have a secret for you. A very simple secret. What is essential is invisible to the eye. It is only with the heart that one sees rightly.
Essential is invisible to the eye. It is only with the heart that one sees rightly.
Yes, it is the time you have spent on your rose that makes her so special.
It makes her rose so special because the time I spent on
her. Men have forgotten the truth, but you must not forget it. You are responsible forever for what you have obtained. You are responsible for your rose. Responsible for your rose.
Upon a switchback.
What do you do here?
I sort out travel. In bundles of a thousand. I send out the trains that carry them. Now to the right, now to the left.
I was so excited by the house every day I came home.
I just knew that there was something there, something in that part of the house. The house, the desert, the stars. What makes it beautiful is that there's something invisible.
Man, they rush around expressways. They turn round and round, and they miss what exactly what they're looking for.
Well, it is strange. Everything is there for us. Pulley, bucket, rope.
We've awakened the well, and it is singing!
The little print is too heavy on me. Leave you.
It's mostly because of the snake. I don't want him to see me too. Maybe just for spite.
I will not leave you. I will not leave you!
It's true. That snake's only half enough poison for one bite.
Little Prince got away from me that night without making a single sound. He was gone, and by the time I caught up with him, he was just all alone.
You should not have come. It will look as if I've suffered, and then you will suffer. But I cannot stay here. This body, it's of no use to me. It's like a shell. I have to leave it behind. But it'll be good, because then, for me, all the stars will be in resting place. And they'll smell of fresh spring water. I'll be amusing. The wells will spill out fresh spring water for me, and they will be like laughing stars for you. I have to return to my flower. I'm responsible for her. She has nothing to protect herself against the world. There now. That's all.
Tell me that he has come back.